You can see my body. Here's my body. You can see my opacious body. You can see my D2, my D3. You can see some opacious body looking through here. There's just a bit about my table occlusion tables. Now let's put it on this model. So we put it on the model. That's it. Make sure my model's wet and clean. That's it. And I want to bring my lower to my upper because this is kind of loose on here. But it's very good to have the right position, the right occlusion position. That's it. Okay. What I do look at this point while I'm doing this is how it's occluding on the other side. If I see that I'm all the way in, that's it. I'm done. Okay. I see if I have any marks still. I do have a small mark here. Clean my brush, put it back. I do have a mark here. Here it is. And I'll just clean it. That's it. So I know that here I have a falsa that I'm going to deal with. Here I have another falsa that I'm going to deal with. It's not exactly where there should be these falsas, but that's going to be okay with me. Okay? So what I'm going to be doing now is just some light condensing so I can do some cutback. To do this condensing, I'm going to do a little bit of tabbing. Okay? And the tabbing, I'm going to be hitting my articulator, you see, until I get some my surface wet. Okay, there we go. Not much, just what's necessary. That's it. I still haven't worked with my enamels. Okay, you see my enamels are still in the powder shape. Once I have dried this just a bit like you've seen now, I'm going to put it aside, I'm going to mix my enamels and be right back with you. Okay, so at this point, I do just some brushing, my brush, and I get ready for my cutback. When I do my cutback, I can take this off the model. And do it easily in my hands. Now, to do my cutback, I can use two different kind of blades. I don't know if you can see this. Let me see if you can see. to make it a little bit closer for you. Okay. I can use a bigger blade or a smaller blade depending on which areas I'm going to be getting the cut done. So keep your eyes open. Now we can just do a very light wetting, and I use my number 4 brush. My number 4. So I'm wetting a little bit my areas, and I'm ready to come in with my enamels. I'm gonna find a slightly humid surface so they can just stick on it. I might use my vibrating brush in this case, so you get to see some new tools, some new techniques. Over the years, I've tried so many techniques. You can do this also with a spatula, without a brush. So, here we are. Let's get back to the model now. So let me remind you. Light, this is my light. This is my medium. This is my translucent. And up here, I got my clear, my transparent. So, let's go for it. Set this up here. Now comes the nice part. My light. You see? I don't know if you can see how I put it on there. How it comes up. Again. I would like for you to see these cones, how they come out, you know, how sharp they can be. Look at that. You see, this I do achieve with this brush. Okay. So, concerning my light, I guess this is what I want. I'm going to be putting also a stratification of light in this area, right here. Just like that. And that's it.